So good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Namaste. I am Daksh. I'm the founder of Blood World Magazine. A very warm welcome to all of you to this very platform where we are trying to create a repository of knowledge, ideas, innovations, perceptions, and what is right now changing or brewing or building in the education sector. So Blood World is basically a magazine meant for teenagers, and the focus of the magazine is to find teenagers who are doing inspiring work in their life and showcasing their inspiration to other teens. To put it in one simple statement, it's teens inspiring teens. Blub as an organization has three verticals, and one of the verticals is research and innovation, and this activity is a part of the research, typical research thing that we're trying to do. We try to create industry white papers from time to time focused on the K-12 education sector, which is simply schools. So at this point, I'm very happy to welcome all of you to the Blub World Web Talk 72nd episode. In the last 71 episodes, more than 900 school leaders have participated on this platform, shared their ideas, innovations, their perception, their worries, their operational issues, their operational solutions, and everything that they were facing in their ecosystems during the lockdown, and what do they think will change post this lockdown. There's just one small little observation that I want to share before this talk actually starts. The way we understand a school, or the definition of a school, or the model of a school, the way we know it, the way we have learned it, and the way we understand it, has already been obliterated. It does not exist anymore. The institution that we are going to reopen needs a new definition now, because there are a lot of bottom line changes which we don't know how to handle, and which we are trying to find solutions for. And a very, a very nice institute in Odisha called the Kalinga Institute. They teach nearly 50,000 tribal children on a single campus without charging them any fees. Their principal was here on this talk some time back, and he shared a very nice observation, and I'm sharing it on his behalf with all of you, that a school is typically a place where the society finds its definition, and we teach the society to come together. And we are right now supposed to teach a paradox, which is social distancing. So how are we going to do that? Because with a lot of masks that teachers and students will be wearing, with just 30% kids, and a lot of sanitization to be taken care of, a lot of physical distancing to be taken care of, I don't know how a school will typically reopen. It'll reopen, but what will reopen, I think, will be something different than a simple school. So thank you so much, people, for being a part of this. Let's listen it from you, that what do you think? How is technology actually interfering, enhancing, innovating, or helping us out in the process of teaching and learning? And since we are all right now blocked into this rectangle box, a very warm welcome again to this box, because most of the teachers and school leaders who are there are experiencing this day in and day out, 7 to 8 hours a day, on this very box they are right now witnessing the world. So thank you so much once again for being here. The format is very simple. I'll explain it to you. You can all see Divya Purohit on the screen. So Divya is basically the timekeeper. So all of you get to speak for a definite period of time. Once it's over, he'll put his one hand up. That is the time then when you should start concluding. Then you have 30 more seconds. Once your time plus 30 seconds are over, he'll put his second hand up. And that is the time that you might get muted. If you get muted, please don't get offended. It is just to finish this activity on time so that none of your schedules get disturbed. So as the format is, this is a virtual roundtable. So every single participant is basically going to share or speak. We have two chairs right now with us, two special guests whom we try to invite in each call so that they bring an external perspective to the whole discussion. So the chair for the roundtable today is Mr. Rajiv Vodulai, and the co-chair is Mrs. Hamsa Venugopal. So they'll typically initiate the talk. Both of them get the initial first 4 minutes each. And then again, for concluding thoughts at the end of the roundtable, other principals get 2 minutes to speak and around 30 more seconds to conclude. So I hope you enjoy this format. And once again, a very warm welcome to the Blub World Web Talk 72nd episode. I hope you enjoy, and let's find out, is technology really teaching? So let's invite the first guest for today, or the chair for the roundtable, Mr. Rajiv Vodulai, Director General, Trade Promotion Council of Robotics and Automation, New Delhi. Rajiv ji, over to you for the next 4 minutes.
Yeah, thank you, Dusk, for the wonderful introduction, and welcome to all of you, all the esteemed ladies and gentlemen, all the guests here today. So the onset, let me also introduce myself. I am Rajiv. I am the Director General for Trade Promotion, as Dusk has already informed. But what do we do in this period of time? We are a council on emerging technology. So this is a very interesting time to be into, even though there is a COVID-like crisis and the whole world is in amidst a pandemic situation. Still, I would put it this way, that it has opened the eyes for so many things, and so many actions are happening around the globe. Actually, we have been working, all our people has been working for overtime, maybe. At odd times, we are having webinars with US, Canada, across the globe. And all of a sudden, from March, the world has become a small place for us. And we have to adapt so fast and so quickly. So I'm really delighted and thrilled that I was invited to this platform so that I could throw some of my experience that I have for last 3 months with all of you. Okay. Firstly, the first thing that I observed is a very fast technology shift that was already there. It was already picking momentum, but during COVID, it has picked momentum so fast in a way that it would be slightly difficult to elaborate it in terms of only by saying and sharing with you. You have to see it at your own with your own eyes. Every day when I say adoption of technology, there's a technology called blockchain, which has been implemented globally. And even during COVID period, only the Supreme Court has passed a judgment to make cryptocurrency legal in India. Okay. So the very objective why. Now, these are very pertinent questions because of the economy, like money, like rupees or dollars, which is getting circulated. Even the digital currency is also getting circulated and picking up at a very fast pace. Okay, so it is really wonderful to know and understand that how blockchain has impacted heavily each and every industry, from education to healthcare to government to everything. Okay, so this is one thing which I have seen a very drastic and fast pickup during COVID. And when it comes to academia, because most of us are from the school domain today, the very big question, what is online learning or virtual learning? In India, I have passed out from IIT Delhi. So even I thought that maybe, yes, a conversion of the offline mode into online is virtual learning. But no, actually, virtual learning is so much about engagement and tools, which India as a country, we are not equipped, and most of the countries across the globe is also not equipped with all the tools. How can we develop in so less time when we have never developed them up to this level? There comes a company called Discovery Education. I'm not promoting them in any way, but I'm just saying that they have been working with the virtual tools for last 20 years. 20 years. Yes, that's the time frame. That took them time to a different level altogether. So I think this is the right time where we have to shift our paradigm slightly and think about and ask us this question, that what is a real virtual learning? What kind of tools do the students need? Okay, or the teachers need, or the schools need when we are talking about virtual learning? And also, I think before I speak much, I'd like to also hear about the viewpoints of everyone. So I think with this, I'd like to pass on my view here.
Thank you so much, Rajiv ji. To again summarize what all you said, that you are typically a council which takes care of emerging technologies, trying to promote them, put them into the right place. And right. Pandemic has opened our eyes to a very new perspective of the world. And change came at such a fast pace that we were not ready for it. Or typically, yes, we were found napping. And right. It woke all of us up.
It took us by surprise, actually.
Absolutely, it took us by surprise. And if you actually look at it from the school's perspective, ye itna edtech implementation hone mein shayad 10 saal lag jate, jo 10 din mein ho gaya, lockdown ke pehle 10 days mein. And so that's the way change actually came on to us. The world has actually shrunk since March. Sach mein bahut chota ho gaya. So connected people are right now. Right. Cryptocurrency like things are now actually finding accreditation. And a very important observation that you share, that virtual learning is not just about content delivery happening online. It's much, much more about engagement and the kind of tools that we're using and the kind of learning outcomes that we achieve out of it. Because right now, if we actually look at the school ecosystem, there's a lot of teaching happening, but we're not sure whether learning is also taking place or not. Because right. that's where the online or the virtual world, you know, fails itself. So the and real virtual learning has to now be discovered by everybody, because education ka ek underlying paradox hai. Before I actually pass on the neck to the next speaker, that underlying paradox is that aap apne se pichli generation se padhte hain aur apne se agli ko padhate hain. To aap hamesha do generations ka backlog apne aage pahunchate hain. And that's where the real challenge appears. So just to, you know, set things into place, this is a bilingual platform. You can use English or Hindi, whatever you're comfortable with. Iske beyond koi language aap use karenge, to I won't be able to get it. Otherwise, it's not a problem. But we would prefer English or Hindi if you use that. Let's now hear it from the co-chair for today, Mrs. Hamsa Venugopal, Education Research Analyst and MD, New Baldwin Group of Institutions, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Hamsa ji, over to you for the next 4 minutes.
Welcome everyone for this wonderful platform. Thank you, Daksh, for such a wonderful introduction. Okay, I would like to quote Steve Jobs here. You know, let's invent tomorrow. Let's invent tomorrow instead of worrying what happened yesterday. Right? Today, this education world, the entire education leaders throughout the world have embraced technology like never before. They've embraced technology to the top notch, and they're using technology where education sector in India, we were like, you know, when the change management from chalk to talk to the tablets and to the technology came, the change management became a very huge topic and very difficult process to induct in schooling sector. I would like to say, as Mr. Daksh quoted very well, 100 days of technology using as done within 10 days, right? So on that note, I would like to come to the topic, is tech really teaching? Dear friends, I would like to share four phases of tech classroom, EdTech classroom. So phase one is creation of pedagogy. Okay, when we are creating pedagogy, there's a huge amount of technology we use. There's a huge amount of connect through online, through different apps and through different articles we get connected. The second step is disembarkment. Second phase of EdTech classroom is disembarkment of this pedagogy. How are we using to transfer the knowledge to the students? In fact, how are we enhancing the knowledge to the students is basically through different smart boards or different PPTs and online teaching. How is this online teaching happening? The entire pedagogy is shifted. You can't just do what you're doing inside the classroom in online teaching. You know, during this short span of time, I think the teaching faculties and the school leaders throughout the world have worked very hard to bring in this shift over the classroom to online, and it is commendable. So as I told, the second phase is disembarkment of the pedagogy. What kind of technology we are using, what apps we are using is also very important for this disembarkation. And third phase of technology is analyzing the effective learning. See, we don't have the touch or face-to-face conversation with the students. It's all about virtual learning. I believe high tech has to be a high touch. That is, we should not forget the emotional quotient of the child. So here comes the efficiency of learning. How the child is learning. How are we going to take the feedbacks? How are we going to do online assessment? All this is happening throughout the technological. We are using different types of technology. Each school leaders are using different technology, but it is technology what we are using. So that's the third phase. And moving on, the fourth phase is analyzing the pedagogy we have created, right? Because as I told you, within a short period, we have created a different strategy, bringing from classroom within the four walls to, as Daksh told, within this four box, right? We have done this complete shift over the pedagogy. So the fourth phase is we need to understand whether the pedagogy what we have created, is it effective? After all the three phases, the fourth phase is analyzing whether your pedagogy is effective, and therefore enhancing and again improvising your pedagogy to make sure the effective learning goes on. Now, why did I explain you these four phases? The question is tech teaching? No, tech is not teaching. Tech is enhancing the teaching. I believe tech is a vehicle and the teacher is a driver. Students are the passengers. It's just driven by the technology. the teacher is the one who is always holding this technology. Definitely, technology is enhancing teaching. A very good example is the pandemic, what we are facing now, how the technology is being used, right? To conclude, dear ladies and gentlemen, I would like to tell that technology cannot replace a great teacher. But if technology is given to a great teacher, learning becomes transformational. Thank you, and over to the next speaker.
Thank you so much, Amsari. To again summarize what you said, that let's invent tomorrow and not worry about the past. That's for sure. You quoted Steve Jobs here. And chalk to talk to tab to finally a smart board and now to a virtual classroom. And usme bhi chalk se thoda piche chale jaye to actually writing on the ground, on the sand, then to a slate, and then finally coming on to where we are right now. And absolutely, creation of pedagogy. Abhi tak we, you know, if we talk the kind of teachers we had, the kind of teaching force we had, the most critical portion was that ye jo platform we use kar rahe hain, it was out of their own syllabus. So they didn't know how to do it. उन्होंने इसके आसपास कोई कंटेंट ना कभी पढ़ा है ना सुना है, एंड उनकी अपस्किलिंग बहुत जल्दी होनी थी. एंड डिसएम्बार्कमेंट ऑफ दिस पेडागोजी की वो एक्चुअली कंटेंट डिलीवरी कैसे हो रही है, लेक्चर मोड ऑनलाइन क्लास में काम नहीं करता, डिस्कशन मोड फिर भी काम कर जाए. एंड क्लासरूम्स कैन नॉट बी रेप्लिकेटेड इन ऑनलाइन क्लास. द कंप्लीट मोड और अंडरस्टैंडिंग और द यू नो वे ऑफ डिलीवरी हैज टू चेंज. एनालाइजिंग द लर्निंग आउटकम, एफिशिएंसी ऑफ लर्निंग, एनालाइजिंग द पेडागोजी, continuous improvisation of what you're doing, and tech is not teaching, the learning bus where the teacher is the driver and the students are the passengers. So let's enjoy the pedagogy of that actual online learning virtual classroom bus. So before we actually move on to the next speaker, abhi tak aap log you were typically listening to people who are here to set a perspective to this. Now we are going to listen to practitioners jo roz subah shayad I think rozana 6 se 8 ghante ye ladai roz lad rahe hain, अलग अलग तरीके के चैलेंजेस अपने अपने इकोसिस्टम्स में फेस कर रहे हैं. सो लेट्स हियर फ्रॉम देम दैट हाउ हैज टेक्नोलॉजी इंपैक्टेड देम एंड एट द सेम टाइम हाउ आर दे इन्फ्लुएंसिंग स्टूडेंट्स विद दिस टेक्नोलॉजी, और क्या क्या नए एक्सपीरियंसेस उनके पास में हैं, एंड व्हाट लर्निंग्स डू दे वांट टू शेयर विद अस टुडे. सो आई इनवाइट द फर्स्ट स्कूल प्रिंसिपल फॉर टुडे, मिस्टर अजय एस आर, Secretary Janana Jyoti Public School, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Ajay ji, over to you for the next 2 minutes.
Hello, good evening, one and all. So thank you for the opportunity, sir. So it is a great pleasure sharing my views. Basically, my school is situated in a rural area, and we are just 1-2 years ahead. A new school started in a rural area. So what problems we are facing? A lot of problems in online issues, online classrooms. Now the classroom has been shifted to virtual realm, shrunk our size of classroom to screens. So the main big problem in the rural areas is the connectivity issues. So many of our parents are calling back to the school and they are just complaining about the connectivity issues. So what we from the school side, we just solved the problem is, we just made activity-based learning rather than to online teaching. So we just started only classes for higher classes like 8th standard to 10th standard. The rest of the classrooms, we just went on to activity-based learning. For example, we just made students to learn what is available in their vicinity. So some of our students are learning farming. They have been experiencing the farming methodologies, tools, and what are the problems agriculture is facing. And some of the students are learning skills like music, other things which is available for them. And the most problem, we as a teacher, even I'm taking online class every day, is screen time. Even myself facing problem with screen time. Even I get a less sleep because of intense teaching for 8 hours a day. The problem is a problem now, but we don't have any solutions because due to COVID-19, we have to rely on technology. Many of technology platforms are helping teaching. So with their best of doing, as our Rajiv sir said, technology was there in the past and it is in the present and it will be in the future. The only thing is tech is not teaching, but it is enhancing, as I'm told. Finally, I can conclude that technology is teaching only to the rural, so only to the urban schools where internet is accessible, the only problem technology is hindrance to rural education, where majority of the students in the rural are still facing problem. And the most important problem again is if in family there are one or two kids, two or more kids, and the accessibility of laptop or mobile phone is one, then again it is a big hurdle. How could the other one access to education? This is the biggest hurdle in the rural areas, sir. And thank you for giving an opportunity to share my view, sir. Over to the next speaker.
Thank you so much, Ajay ji, to again summarize that rural schools are facing a big, big problem, that's for sure, because technology infrastructure nahi hai. Just to share a fact, India has network percolation of only 25% in rural in India. And I'm not talking about internet percolation, it's about network percolation. करीबन 55,000 विलेजेस अक्रॉस इंडिया ऐसी हैं जहां पे नेटवर्क ही नहीं है किसी भी टेलीकॉम ऑपरेटर का. इट्स नॉट अबाउट इवन हैविंग द इंटरनेट. एंड एक बहुत बड़ा जो चैलेंज अभी रूरल इंडिया में खड़ा हो गया है, अक्रॉस रूरल इंडिया वी वर ट्राइंग टू बिल्ड एन एजुकेशन इकोसिस्टम और उसका एपिसेंटर था मिड डे मील्स. एंड द प्रॉब्लम इज अ मिड डे मील कैन नॉट बी डिलीवर्ड वर्चुअली. एंड दैट्स वेयर द होल इकोसिस्टम एक्चुअली गॉट क्रम्बल्ड डाउन और वो अब चल ही नहीं पा रहा है. सो वी राइट नाउ हैव टू थिंक ऑन इस डिजिटल डिस्पैरिटी को कम कैसे करें एंड एक्चुअली ट्राइंग टू फाइंड वेज वेयर वी डोनेट डिजिटल रिसोर्सेज एंड ट्राई टू बिल्ड एन इकोनॉमी जस्ट आउट ऑफ गिफ्टिंग सो दैट रूरल इंडिया भी वापस इन वर्चुअल प्लेटफॉर्म्स पे आ सके और पढ़ सके एंड लर्निंग कंटिन्यू हो सके. सो थैंक यू सो मच अजय जी फॉर शेयरिंग दोज अमेजिंग थॉट्स विद अस. लेट्स नाउ इनवाइट द नेक्स्ट प्रिंसिपल फॉर टुडे, मिस्टर इरफान बेग मिर्जा, स्कूल लीडर, ग्रेस मॉडल स्कूल, हैदराबाद, तेलंगाना. इरफान जी, ओवर टू यू फॉर द नेक्स्ट 2 minutes.
So myself, Irfan, from Grace Model School. I'll give you a small brief about myself. So my school is in Hyderabad from last 13 years. And we are catering to our school is a very low budget private school where we are catering the students from our parents who are like auto rickshaw drivers and all, who just with a fee structure of 300 to 750 per month. You can understand. Annual fees jo hamari hai, 3600 se 9000 rupees. सालाना फीस हम ले रहे हैं नर्सरी से 10th क्लास तक. उस तरह के पेरेंट्स जो उतना कम पे कर सकते हैं या उतनी मुश्किल से उन लोग को पढ़ाई जाने के लिए बहुत बड़ी बात है, उनको हम पढ़ा रहे हैं. और बहुत सारे तो फर्स्ट लर्नर्स हैं. और ये पैंडेमिक आने के बाद तो बहुत बड़ा इशू हो गया हमारे लिए कि किस तरह पढ़ाया क्या पढ़ाए. और हमारे पास एट प्रेजेंट 1300 बच्चे पढ़ रहे हैं मेरे स्कूल में. और इनके पास अगेन द सेम इशूज, गैजेट्स नहीं है. गैजेट्स अगर है तो फिर उसको किस तरह यूज़ करेंगे. इंटरनेट का मसला आ जाता है, घर में एक ही फोन है. लेकिन हमें कुछ ना कुछ तो करना है. तो इसके लिए हम लोग जूम क्लासेस लेना थोड़ा मुश्किल हो रहा है हमारे लिए, क्योंकि सारे बच्चों के पास एक ही टाइम पे फोन रहे या फिर उनके पास इंटरनेट फैसिलिटी रहे, वो बड़ा इशू है. तो इस हिसाब से हम लोग क्या किए, सारे थोड़े जो भी एप्स अवेलेबल है उन्हें मिक्स करते हुए इंटरैक्टिव बनाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं. एक तो सॉरी तो एक ये हो रहा है कि जो ऐप्स है दूसरे, उन ऐप्स को हम अपने पढ़ाने से पहले उसे रेडी कर ले रहे हैं ताकि जो भी चीज़ पढ़ाई जा रही है वो थोड़ा बच्चों को इंटरेक्ट. क्योंकि एक क्लास में अगर हम जब पढ़ाते हैं तो 40 मिनट में सारे बच्चों को का कंसंट्रेशन जमा के रखना है बहुत मुश्किल सी बात है. अब ये तो ऑनलाइन क्लासेस हो गए जहाँ पर पता नहीं बच्चा क्या कर रहा है, पीछे किस तरह बैठा हुआ है, किस एनवायरमेंट में है. तो इसलिए हम लोग ये कर रहे हैं कि भाई जब जूम क्लास में पढ़ा रहे हैं तब कोशिश ये करें कि जो क्रिस्पी वीडियोस है, यानी हम हमारी तरफ से कोई नया वीडियो नहीं बना रहे ना कोई क्लास ले रहे, क्रिस्पी वीडियोस अवेलेबल है यूट्यूब पे ऑलरेडी, जो बहुत ही 2 या 3 मिनट के होते हैं और बहुत ही शानदार वीडियोस है. फॉर एग्जांपल डोंट मेमोराइज बोलकर एक है जिनके वीडियोस मैथ्स में साइंस में 2 to 3 मिनट्स के है, जिसके जरिए हम लोग वो वीडियोस बता रहे हैं. और इमीडिएटली उसके बाद गूगल फॉर्म के जरिए उनका एक सर्वे ले रहे हैं. और साथ में जो एप्स यूज किए जा रहे हैं वो है कुहूट और क्विजेस. कुहूट ऐप और क्विजेस में ये अच्छी चीज़ है कि भाई बच्चे गेम्स क्यों खेलना पसंद करते हैं तो इमीडिएटली वो लोग आंसर देते हैं और उनके रैंकिंग पता चलती है. साथ में ये दो ऐप्स जो है ऑफलाइन भी यूज़ कर सकते हैं, बाद में कभी भी बच्चे असाइन कर सकते हैं और उसमें काम कर सकते हैं. तो इससे हो रहा है कि भाई ये 40 मिनट्स को हम लोग कोशिश पूरी कर रहे हैं कि इसे एक्टिव बना सके और हर बच्चा पार्टिसिपेट कर सके. ऐसा ना हो कि वन वे हो जाए और बस एक तरफ से ही पढ़ा जा रहा है. और गूगल फॉर्म और गूगल क्लास में भी यूज की जा रही है बट नॉट अप टू द मार्क. लेकिन ये जो ऐप से बहुत काम हेल्प कर रहे हैं हमारे लिए. थैंक यू, होप आई कंप्लीटेड.
थैंक यू सो मच इरफान जी. सो टू समराइज व्हाट यू सेड, दैट बहुत लो इनकम ग्रुप को आप केटर कर रहे हैं, 1300 बच्चे आपके पास में है जिनकी लर्निंग कंटिन्यू करना बहुत बड़ा चैलेंज है अपने आप के अंदर, बच्चे का 40 मिनट तक कॉन्सेंट्रेशन रोके रखना जिसको आप फाइनली यू आर डूइंग इट थ्रू यूट्यूब एंड फाइंडिंग क्रिस्प कॉन्टेंट दैट्स अवेलेबल ऑलरेडी एंड यू आर ट्राइंग टू यूज दैट एंड टेस्टिंग वाया गूगल फॉर्म्स एंड यू हैव ऑलरेडी फाउंड टूल्स जो ऑफलाइन काम कर जाते हैं विच इज वेरी गुड. So this is where we typically, I would like to, you know, share one trait of this very platform. Whenever we try to create, curate a call like this, we bring in the maximum variety that's possible and the ups and the downs and the best, you know, try to build the whole value spectrum of schools within a single call. Taki jo discussion hai, wo keval upper and better schools ke liye na reh jaye. Wo discussion thoda sa aur inclusive ho, wo thoda sa aur naye perspectives ho. So thank you so much, Irfan ji, for being here. And, most importantly, I've just shared two small ideas. जो lockdown जब शुरू हुआ था तब दो schools ने हम लोगों के साथ share किए थे शुरुआत की talks में, and they shared this कि अगर आप there's a small village पड़ुआ called West Bengal जहाँ पे internet नहीं है, so there one of the schools there gave a very nice assignment to their kids that create a custom dictionary at home कि घर पे रोज 5 नए words उस dictionary में add कीजिए and once the school reopens bring that dictionary to the school. There's one school in Gujarat. They gave a very innovative in Odisha, Sundarbhanj. They gave an innovative assignment that write a wisdom diary every day. रोज एक डायरी में एंट्री कीजिए कि आपने क्या अच्छा किया और क्या गलत किया. So that when you come back to school, we're able to evaluate कि आपका wisdom या value education में आप कितना grow कर गए. So there are a lot of innovative things that people are doing in Blab के platform पे. You can go and actually find 100 such ideas जो कि आप अपने schools में experiment कर सकते हैं at this point. जो अलग 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 geographies से लोगों ने share किए हैं. In Nepal, they started a class called problem solving engineering. They told kids that go into the kitchen, find the problem that your mother is facing and give it an engineering solution. Aur usko document kijiye, and if you can actually build a product around it, try to do that. So a lot of innovative things people have done during this lockdown. So thank you so much, Irfanji. Let's listen to the next speaker for today. Mrs. Madhuparna, Andrews Principal, Purushottam, Bhag Jit Shankha Academic School, Kolkata, West Bengal. I think I pronounced it wrong. I'm sorry.
Good evening, everyone. This is Madhuparna Andrews, and I'm from Purushottam Bhag Jit Shankha Academic School in Kolkata, from West Bengal. So mine is ICSE-ISE school, and I would like to start with a quotation. Sometimes we are tested not to show our weaknesses, but to discover our strengths. So this is, I think, is very apt. Though our school is a high-tech school in the sense it's a new school and we have got lots of technology being exploited to the optimum at different levels. But all of a sudden, honestly speaking, during the lockdown, we were not ready to shift to a school which is within the mobile phones or laptops of the students. So that also has been a big challenge as a school leader, as a disciplinarian. I've been stopping them from getting mobile phones to school. And now the whole school is being run on the mobile phones of the students. So that's another paradox of education, I guess. Now in our school, we have been utilizing technology for teaching online classes, posting of the videos in WhatsApp group, what we began with when we are taking assignments. Even we are having parent-teacher meeting through online Zoom and GMeet. We are conducting programs all over the school, programs like Rabindra Jayanti. It's a very famous celebration of Bengal. And also we are doing motivational talks with parents, counseling of the students and parents as well during this pandemic, as this lockdown has affected the parents to a great extent. Like we are reading the newspapers, we are coming across, we are all facing a problem, you know, regarding the fees, the commitment, the obligations which the parents are expected to fulfill. So that is another challenge which we are dealing with in this online classes, which has come up, that why we pay fees when there are no physical teaching. But we are giving our best. We are giving them various activities. We are giving them club activities, extracurricular, along with teaching for their holistic development. But that has really become a challenge, I would say, as a school leader. Now, we have also done the summer camps with our children, you know, like they can be engaged for 10 days summer vacation break. Various activities were done with them to give them idea of life skills. We have got various clubs functioning even in urban area. We are teaching them how germination of seeds take place. What is the way they can do social service by making mask and, you know, just giving it to others. So all these are being taught to our children online. And we have got a psychologist in our school who is also intervening and helping us with different things wherever we see there is a kind of, you know, boosting up of the morale of the students or the parents are required. Now, we are going to have a very big program in our school, that is the Prize Day online, so which is scheduled for Saturday. So lots of activities we are doing actually, but one or two things I would say, like even if we are using technology, I am facing certain issues regarding the absenteeism of students in senior levels. You know, because senior level students are on for 3 hours, 3.5 hours, Monday to Friday, sometimes Saturday classes are there. But then when it comes to the attendance, we see they say, ma'am, our net pack finished. So that is another extra expenditure of the students. What is lab, you know, because lab is a part of their science 9, 10, 11, 12, but we are not being able to do that experiments with them physically. So teachers are coming, doing the experiments, video is being shared, but to do it yourself, learning by doing is a different thing altogether, which they are not getting the chance to.
Madhupurna ji, thank you so much. You added a lot of new content to the discussion, but the time was actually over, but we'll try to come back to you if it's possible. To summarize what you said, that you are a high-end school जो technology implement कर सकता था, लेकिन आप लोगों के लिए भी शुरुआत में एकदम से implement करना was a difficulty. Online events have been very successful. Community activities बहुत engaging रही हैं. There's one school in Gujarat, they gave a nice assignment. They told kids that do a daily news report on your surroundings. कि आपके surroundings में क्या-क्या change हो रहा है, उस पर एक रोज एक daily news report बनाइए. And psychological intervention जो आप कर रहे हैं, which is very important. And एक चीज जिसमें schools across the nation बहुत successful हुए हैं during the whole lockdown and even right now, you have kept the parents and the students' anxiety at bay. आपने anxiety को बहुत अच्छे से control कर लिया parents के लिए भी, क्योंकि बच्चों को घर पे इतने समय engage रखना बहुत आसान काम नहीं है. And absenteeism of senior students, I would just like to quote on this very platform a very senior principal of the leading school of India, which is based out of Mumbai. They came and they admitted on this very platform that they started online classes, but they had to stop them because of the kind of digital pranks that the students were doing. Kyunki itne tech savvy bacche hain ki unhone padhana mushkil kar diya tha. And they finally, what they did was, they started teaching technology to kids during these online classes. Unhone bachchon ko coding padhana shuru kar diya, simulations banane shuru kar diye, so that bachche at least engaged rahe aur wo pranks badhe na. So thank you so much, Madhupurna ji, for adding that. Let's now invite the next guest, Mr. G. Rajkumar, Principal, Shine High School, Hanamkonda, Warangal, Telangana. Rajkumar ji, over to you for the next 2 minutes.
Thank you for giving this wonderful opportunity. Let me introduce myself. This is Rajkumar. Greetings from Telangana, everybody. Hope you're doing well. I hope so. We are also same situation, everyone getting same over the India and over the world. Now the thing is that topic is tech really teaching? On that point, I would like to talk one point. The popular people on popular platform here see technology cannot replace a teacher. Technology cannot replace a teacher. I strongly believe this. See, of course, socially we are distant, but virtually we connected. We are teaching, but is children learning? The point is that it is not a point of completing our syllabus curriculum through the cameras, through the software we are giving education to them, but how far it is correct? I don't believe the software has not had much positive impact as far as I can tell. So these issues here, I would like to talk about this internet connections and the cameras and this visual, all software technology and online classes. I myself give my suggestion to you, it is not good for children, physical and mental. Physically and mentally, they are not at all strong enough in learning process. Because of the parents, of course, they are sitting in front of the cameras for half hour, 2 hour, 3 hour. three of us. But being a parent, I'm also being a parent, I can share my views. It is not good. This is not good. And the offline teaching, some of the schools are here, the preloaded videos are being uploading in websites and uploading the worksheets and expecting homework from the children. The tech guru is not value to the children. And coming to the my staff, being a principal, I can talk about my staff, how they are facing the problems while teaching the classes. Some of the students, Madam Hamsa, Madam said that tech enhancing the learning, something like that. Okay, of course, sometimes it's enhancing, but see, some naughty things will be that they are abusing the technology. Teachers are facing some problems. I would like to share through this platform. So teachers also coming to us and explaining, sir, this is the situation happening while teaching. So how could we avoid them? So what are the controls we are using in the software? This is a big issue. And they are not technically enough good to operate the softwares. When we design, when we arrange the cameras and board and everything, of course, they are coming to schools and teaching, but it is not able to control them in such way. And coming to the point here, health point of students, few students are having, see, how many are using this high-level end devices, laptops, IPS displays, smartphone displays. This kind of displays will give a lot of bad impact on their health issues. So instead of this, I can say school means all-round development. Not only teaching, school means all-round development. They must need physical activity and mental activity. Because of these two, they can they are going to become a good citizens of this country. They can create harmony in the country, peace in the world. Otherwise, it is very, very problematic to us. So this is, I want to share with you, sir. Thank you for giving a great opportunity. Technology cannot replace a teacher. I repeat this, technology cannot replace it. Teacher must interact with the children. Teacher must mingle with the children and ask everything, and the teacher have a good relation between tech guru. It should not.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, G. Rajkumar ji, for sharing this, that tech cannot replace a teacher. And shayad abhi to kahin pe bhi teacher aur zyada critical ho gaya hai, teacher ki understanding aur critical ho gayi hai. And teaching is happening, but learning is bad. Ye baat bahut had tak sahi bhi hai. Just some days back, we had a behavioral scientist come on very this platform, retired Colonel Sudeep Mukherjee. He shared a very recent research that a kid who is typically looking at a screen like this and trying to learn, he has an attention span of only 8 seconds. On every 9th second, you have lost him. He has started daydreaming. So, aap aisa content ki bachcha har 8th second baad bhi aap se engaged rahe, aapki baat sunta rahe, is the new challenge. And the problem is, when a student looks at you through this box on a screen, he compares you with a celebrity. And aapki presentation skill aur celebrity ki presentation skills mein bahut fark hai, aur wo bachcha wahin pe aapse disconnect ho jata hai. So that's a very new challenge that's coming in. And yes, bad screen time is something that's impacting everywhere. Uske solutions niklenge, but as of now, there are not a lot of very definite things that we know. But ye hai ki we should find new and new innovations and solutions to say, उस बैड स्क्रीन टाइम को भी गुड स्क्रीन टाइम में कन्वर्ट कर सके. बिकॉज वन थिंग दैट वी नो फॉर श्योर, टेक्नोलॉजी इज हियर टू स्टे, एंड ये तो कहीं नहीं जा रही है. एंड व्हेन इट्स हियर, लेट्स ट्राई टू लिव विद इट एंड फाइंड मोर बेटर सॉल्यूशंस टू इट. थैंक यू सो मच राजकुमार जी. लेट्स लिसन टू द नेक्स्ट स्पीकर फॉर टुडे, मिस वैष्णवी राज, प्रिंसिपल, रॉयल कॉनकॉर्ड इंटरनेशनल स्कूल, बेंगलुरु, कर्नाटक. वैष्णवी जी, ओवर टू यू.
गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी. आई एम वेरी happy to present my ideas in front of you today. I'm privileged also because I got a little late my chance. Most of the speakers have already given a lot of the problems what they are facing. They have shared it here. And I would like to tell you a few things. This pre-COVID was more of skill set, and the post-COVID is more of mindset. And pre-COVID, it's more of learning. post-COVID is more of unlearning, learning, and relearning. Pre-COVID is more of aggression and behavior, and post-COVID is more of positivity and hope. Whether you like it, dislike it, and we cannot change it, we have to accept the situation and move on. That is what I have this attitude. So basically, as you people have shared, we also have certain, we are associated with our partners like Prodigy, where we have gamified these days. As you people are telling, the attention span is decreasing day by day, and it's as per the age also. So what they like, let us give in that form only. See, if you like, if you like upma, I will give you upma. If you don't like upma, I will prepare that as dosa and give it to you. See, the way they are not against your teaching, they are against the monotony of your teaching. That's what I have heard in most of the talks. Even I have experienced it in my career also. So children generally, what happens, they become restless, and they don't listen to you at all, because they don't like that monotony. And give them the variety, as a couple of schools have done the counseling session and other things, even we have stepped into those things. And what happens, all the whole family will be in the same house, siblings rivalry will be there, and parents, their pressure and putting their pressure and aggression on the children, all this came up in that discussion also. So this is the high time. Everybody, they are also facing a lot of pressure financially. The affordability has gone down. And all this, sometimes what happens, impact on the children. The child has to take a lot of burden and pressure, right? So in this direction, we also worked with the parents. And we have given a lot of solutions to them. We are also coming up very innovative ideas. In one of the cities where they have put the speakers, where there is no technology reaching areas, the speakers has been put and for the audibility of the children. This is how the innovative things come up. At the time of crisis only, we think of new ideas. So we have to welcome that and go with it and make use of the technology very well. Thank you for giving time, and I hope you enjoyed
Thank you so much, Vaishnavi ji. To summarize, that pre-COVID was skills, and post-COVID was a lot more relearning and typically unlearning and try to upskill yourself. Gamification of teaching and monotony of teaching is the real challenge. Abhi sabse bada challenge yehi hai ki jo curriculum hum padha rahe hain, that curriculum has not been aligned to this teaching. Hum log keval ek offline class ko online class mein replicate karne ki koshish kar rahe hain, jo ki ho nahi raha hai. And that's where the real challenge is coming. And I think the upma dosa simile should actually go ahead. Ki jo usse pasand hai, aap usse wo serve kar dijiye. Just find a new taste to it. And home atmosphere is actually influencing bahut naye tarike ka psychological burden bachchon pe aur parents pe simultaneously aa gaya hai. Kyunki affordability, the economy, everything, when it's going down, as a community hum wo challenge face kar rahe hain, it gets even more difficult ki bacche ka what I can say comfort level and parent ki sanity bani rahe aur uski sanity bani rahe is where the real challenge comes up. Kyunki abhi bahut sara pressure hai jo hum sabhi jhel rahe hain apne sabke gharon mein. But let's see how to diffuse it even more, and shayad itne hi aur interaction se thoda sa wo diffuse aur ho jayega. And again, I would like to repeat, schools ne kafi had tak us stress ko diffuse kiya hai during the lockdown. Bhale hi parent ye keh raha ho ki school ki hum online classes se pareshan hain, kisi bhi cheez se wo pareshan ho, but bacche ko engage rakke us ghar ke atmosphere ko kafi healthy schools ne banaye rakha tha. So thank you to all the schools for that. Let's listen to the next speaker for today, Mr. Samir Arora, Vice Principal, Legacy School, Bengaluru, Karnataka. Samir ji, over to you for the next 2 minutes.
Thank you so much. I'm just trying to, my internet is a little bit slow, so kindly allow me a minute. There could be a lack of voice. I think we're having this interesting debate or conversation, if I may call it, on multiple platforms for we've been forced basically to get into the modality of a teaching in a way it never imagined. Teaching through technology is a buzzword, and hence the question is tech really teaching? But I think before we understand is tech really teaching, if we try to deconstruct the whole idea of the sentence into two forms, what is technology and what is teaching? So as far as I think, we're in a very layman's language, technology is basic knowledge you try to put into practical use to solve a problem with a piece of equipment, which could be very simple as a screwdriver or maybe as complex as space shuttle. I think before I also want to deconstruct one norm here that, that teaching and teachers are words which are quite wrapped around. So we need to see each word individually. And teaching is a very simple process of attending people's needs, experiences, and feelings, and making sure that there are specific interventions to help them learn and learn the way they want to learn, like ma'am just mentioned. So teaching is also linear. It can be simple chalk and talk method in the class with the resources like book, kit, or even a human being in the class. And there is a non-linear method of teaching. I mean, of course, I cannot empathize as much. I can empathize as much with schools which are under-resourced. And some of you talked about your challenges. But in our international education school pedagogy, we try to create an ecosystem or environment that facilitates the interest of learner or seeker with or without technology to acquire new skills or to master old skills. So the larger question is not if the tech is teaching. The larger question is technology facilitating effective teaching, enabling teacher in the process to ensure learning is differentiated, learning is scaffolded, learning is collaborative, and hence leading to development of mindset in our children, just like ma'am said, that post-COVID and pre-COVID mindset into a growth mindset where learner moves from I can't do it to I can do it. So I think here I'm pointing out here, the teacher in the process is not the conventional form of an adult supervising a learner in the confines of four walls. If technology is going to be used in isolation as a replacement of human interaction between the facilitator and learner, it indeed is not teaching. I completely resonate with some of you what you said, that just looking at a mobile phone and learning a lesson and watching a video is not teaching. And I know a lot of institutes and schools around the world have just tried to replicate the classroom experience in an online model without even thinking, is that teaching? Of course, it is not teaching. But if the technology is enabling human interaction to enhance the learning experience by personalizing it, the technology is indeed aiding effective teaching. I don't know, some of you must have seen, there was a school in Kerala where the teacher was using augmented reality through WhatsApp by creating an animals in the class or by creating a solar system in the class. I found that a phenomenally interesting methodology and a pedagogy of teaching. So I think what technology has been able to do for education or for teaching is something important to look at before we conclude technology is not teaching. I think it has bridged the gap of access. It doesn't matter how old you are. It doesn't matter what socioeconomic background you have. If you're learning and you have access to basic technology like a smartphone, you can learn. Technology is an important tool, just like furniture and fixture in schools. So how do we optimize that tool is depending upon us. I think the ease of access to content any time of the term or year beyond the confines of physical space or beyond the confines of just having a human being standing in front of you and explaining your method has helped personalizing teaching and learning to a great extent. Augmented reality, virtual reality, AI is offering. And I'm talking about schools, some of the schools who've adopted innovative methods and some of the organizations I know. There's an organization called Mekshala in Bangalore, which is doing phenomenal work with scientific content for rural schools on just a smartphone. So I think it's offering immense magical potential to build a complete learning ecosystem, which is purposefully embedding technology into teaching learning process. I think in our ecosystem, we are advantaged, we are fortunate, we have an Apple ecosystem. So all we need is just to get into a class, use our smartphone or an iPad or MacBook to just connect with children. But I think overall, there is a huge potential. There is a huge opportunity for all of us to synergize. Technology is the way to go. Blended learning is the way to go. So I think just to conclude, in the name of education, we've been doing wrong things quite well for a long period of time. It's time we embrace technology and humanize technology in teaching and not use it as a substitute. And that's just my small bit. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Samirji. To actually humanize technology is very important. And now, बहुत सारी गलतियाँ education sector में थीं या बहुत सारी ऐसी चीजें जो काफी समय से चलती आ रही थीं, we were just brushing them under the carpet. COVID उस सबको ऊपर लेके आ गया और हमें उस हर एक को अब resolve करना पड़ रहा है. And the school as a structure has become absolutely transparent क्योंकि हर class को parent attend कर रहा है और आपके हर शब्द को parent scrutinize कर रहा है और school के अंदर CRM department तो होता नहीं, तो parent manage करना एक बहुत बड़ा challenge हो गया है. आपका स्कूल साइज अगर पहले 1000 बच्चों का या 1000 अटेंड करने वाले पार्टिसिपेंट्स का था तो अभी वो 4-5 हजार का हो गया है क्योंकि बच्चे के साथ उसके पेरेंट्स हैं, शायद ग्रैंड पेरेंट्स हैं या कोई कजन है या कोई फ्रेंड भी है. सो द इकोसिस्टम हैज एक्चुअली रिवर्स्ड इटसेल्फ और अब आपको जो थ्रॉटल आपके पास था पढ़ाने का वो थ्रॉटल अब बच्चे के पास चला गया पढ़ने का. सो द प्रॉब्लम इज यू नीड एक्टिव लर्नर्स नाउ. केवल एक एक्टिव टीचर से काम नहीं चलेगा. an active learner banane ke liye, the pedagogy and the curriculum is what we don't have. And that's where the real need is up, that we need to create that, or uska implementation and application is what we need to understand. Like the Kerala AR example that you gave, and gap of access is the real limitation. Ease of access of content has made learning much, much more personalized, much easier. Technology ke bahut sare fayde have already come in, and since you're already in an Apple ecosystem, to aap technology ka best end mein hain aur us best end ko utilize karne ki koshish kar rahe hain. And we on this platform trying to bring the best and of technology and the best of non-tech platforms or non-tech communities, so that we get a, you know, good understanding of the spectrum that we are trying to deal with. Even if you like look at the new education policies draft, jo Government of India ne thode din pehle nikali hai, jo abhi notify nahi hui hai, even that needs to go back to the drawing board. Kyunki ab reality hi change ho gayi hai, to uske hisab se policies ko change hona hoga. In every such call, we try to bring one policy maker. Today we don't have, just in the last call we had one of the policy experts from Niti Aayog come in. In the 100th episode, we'll be having the Honorable Lok Sabha speaker come on this, and kuch sabse achhe ideas hum unko denge so that they get implemented or used up in the policy making process. So thank you so much, Samir ji. Let's listen to the next guest for today, Ms. Jyoti Nim, who's an experienced principal from Betul, Madhya Pradesh. Jyoti ma'am, over to you for the next 2 minutes.
Hello. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for giving this platform the space. Before we, so many people, they have experienced personalities, they have spoken about this topic. Is tech really teaching? When we talk about is tech really teaching in this present scenario, pandemic situation, I think the necessity of this technology has come up in this situation, that we have to be very much dependent on the technology. When we talk about online classes, virtual classes for the students, as the team leader, it was difficult in the beginning, as when we see previous time and present scenario, the demand is much more. Before teaching, the teachers they have to be techno savvy first of all. And though my school, it's a new school, and we use this lead school curriculum, so lead apps are there, so parent app is there, so parents are much more aware of this technology. They have to be. Without this, it would be very much difficult. And during this time, everyone got this platform, like students as well as they know about this Google Meet as well as WebEx, this Zoom platform, how to like online classes also. As the school, we before that ma'am also told like different yoga day celebrations. We have started with parent orientation program beginning. We have new parent orientation because we didn't get in the new session to call the parents. We had planned, but suddenly it all happened. Everything happened in the WebEx platform also, like orientation program. Then open house also, we have conducted one. Then class-wise also, parent meeting also, like parent introduction also. Though like I feel junior classes, like pre-primary, it is very difficult for them to sit for a longer time. Time schedule, when we divide the classrooms, like lessons also in like 32 periods or one period for them, as it was previously told, like 8 minutes, after that 9th minute, the retention, like, you know, the child is getting distracted in that way. So different videos are prepared and sent to like live classes, online classes, live teacher talk, as well as offline also. We tried like experts, they used to prepare their class, like topic related classes, and they used to deliver to the students also. And no doubt what I feel, technology, it's like helping, it is needed. This scenario now, the world, this situation, it is needed. Without that, we can understand like students, how they are without something is better than nothing. In that scenario, like a child without learning, if in this technology the child is learning, we can understand the classroom teacher situation cannot be like in the online classes, it cannot in that way same. But the thing is that not 100%, 75% the child is learning. When in the classroom also PPTs, showing PPTs and videos also helpful and interesting for the parent students, the same way it is also helpful for the students also. So many things are like what I feel. Technology really helping for the students as well as the teachers, and that this is the best thing that we all are connected. Who all are the like the eminent personalities here, those who have spoken, this is the way. I don't think so really without technology I could have or you could have met, we could have met with each other. So this is the platform that we are listening to everyone. We are discussing the pros and cons as well as the, like our views where we are sharing.
Thank you, Jyoti ma'am, to finally tell us about the more of operational issues that you face and how you typically got over them. Let's now hear it. All the practitioners have now completed their thoughts and shared their opinions. Let's now hear it from the chairs, their concluding thoughts. I first invite the co-chair for today, Ms. Hamsa Venugopal. Over to you, ma'am, for concluding thoughts for the next 2 minutes.
Oh, hi. So it was a wonderful talk. Everyone gave your insight through your experience, through your journey of online teaching and through your journey of technical usage. You know, I understood a lot about what has happened, and I appreciate everyone for doing a wonderful job in today's work world. And everyone's objective today here is only one thing, that is giving the best to the students, right? We are making sure that the journey of education is not stopped. So for that, a great applaud for everyone here. See, there are 3 points which I would like to bring to your notice. Is one of the speaker told the technology is decrying the students' moral values, and there's a lot of problems in technology. I would like to say, you please tell me which doesn't have a bad face. Every coin has two sides of it, be it good or bad. It all depends on us as an educator, how we are leading it, how we are training it, you know, how we are bringing it to the notice. Like in our school, we had, before we start the online classes, we had online etiquettes. You know, we had this workshop continuously for 3 days, which talks about online etiquettes, what you have to and what you should not, and what would be the circumstances if you do, what is the loss of knowledge, and what is the loss the child goes through if he or she takes the wrong path. So it completely depends on us how we teach them. We cannot tell technology is bad, technology is good. When the need arises, when the requirement arises, you better use it. Okay, so that is one I would like to say. And one more, I heard that online, as I told you, the online etiquettes. And we are talking about online classes for 1 hour, 2 hours, or in an interval of 3 hours max. But here the teaching should not stop for 1 or 2 hours. We believe that, you know, teaching has to create a loop for the students, you know. The students, once you finish this 30 minutes or 40 minutes of the session, the student has to be put in an invisible loop, you know. He or she should keep thinking about what teaching happened till the next class arises. So what happens, he's walking, he thinks about your teaching. He's sitting, he thinks about his teaching. For example, he's playing with the ball and he thinks about physics. You know, that kind of pedagogy has to be created. That kind of pedagogy has to be designed so that you keep them in loop for 24 hours. You know, we have to use something called as metacognition. You throw a question and ask the students why the question arises. You can ask them, why is the sky blue, not red? Let them think and come back with it. You're going to have wonderful answers. Trust me, I did this in my research institute. It is wonderful. And one small story I would like to share, as I am a education research analyst and a managing director of New Baldwin Group of Institution. I'm an international research analyst. I would like to share a small, very small story which happened in Japan, a country of technology. Yeah, everyone knows what happens in Japan. So there was a school in Japan where they inserted an instrument called teaching instruments. Okay, this was a research part which happened. They installed a small instrument, which is a teaching instrument. Of course, it's a screen, which had all the videos of a particular topic, which had all the teaching materials. It had online tests, online assessments, everything. Complete of the technology was placed in the front of the students. After a month, we did an analysis of giving them a test, you know, assessment, how much they scored. To our shock, it was 100%. And we thought, okay, let's keep this aside. Let's do a conflict management. Let's do critical thinking. Let's do application-oriented assessment. And we did an application-oriented assessment. That is what they have learned. Are they able to imply that on the real life? And shockingly, the result was 1%. So this gives you an answer. Technology can give you information. It can give you proper information, but without the presence of human, without the touch of emotion, there is no application-oriented knowledge. There's no proper transformation of knowledge. So this was a small research story what I would like to share and conclude my speech. And I would conclude by saying that, you know, let's pray God and let's thank God that today we all are sitting here and talking that we are blessed with a good health. And let's thank God and pray God that this phase of COVID goes off soon, and let's meet our students, you know, let's receive the love of our students very fast in our classrooms, and let's take the learning what we had now, what critical thinking and design thinking we learned during this pandemic. Let's take this to our schools. Let's take this and learn. This is a beautiful learning what we have to take, and let's pray God these days passes soon and let's meet our students soon. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Amsaji, for that amazing story and that amazing observation. Let's now hear it from the chair for the roundtable. Some concluding thoughts from Mr. Rajiv Godolai. Rajivji, over to you.
Am I on mute? So it was really a very interesting discussion, I must say. And hats off to all the educators who are here today amidst the COVID pandemic, because it has hard hit the industry. So myself being connected with the industry more, all I could say is that there are so many changes that are happening in the industry at the fast pace, which we have never seen before, And believe me, it's the fact. We cannot run away from that. I have seen some of the educators from very light schools and some from maybe not so that much in terms of technology. But the fact remains the fact that the global change is going to happen in terms of technology. Technology cannot be a teacher. Teacher, a mentor, a coach can never be replaced. But what we have done in the Indian scenario, we need to play more of a coach and give them a freedom of developing ideas, developing design thinking, as rightly said by Hamsa, my co-chair, and also computational thinking. So all these things can be combined. Whether any government policies comes in this regard or not, irrespective, it is the role and responsibility of every educator to educate themselves first from those point that let's give a problem and think how many solutions could be there in around the problem. Whether we use technology or not, that's the secondary question. First thing is the thinking process has to change, number one. Secondly, yes, it is imperative that technology is helping us immensely, and the world is changing, industries are changing very fast. Day before yesterday, I got a call from HP asking for 2,000 engineers certified in blockchain. Fortunately, unfortunately, we have in India total 40,000 that do not highly certified and global certified. So that's the scene right now. So I'd like to conclude that we have to change our paradigm, the approach. Okay, and technology being a tool, always an enabler. Okay, so it will always be. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity.
Thank you so much. Yeah. So we all need to understand at this point that we have to learn technology so that we tame it and it does not tame us. Because the kind of advancement that we are seeing, the way we are creating data and the way that data is being utilized, this is the time when we need to really get into it and understand as an educator, as a leader, that we have to select from an array of platforms that are available to us. And just that selection needs a lot of knowledge. So as an educator, as a school leader, if you're choosing an edtech platform, learn about it a lot. And most important, abhi, as of this moment, the most education technology platforms that we are using, we are not using them to solve education issues. We are using them to solve communication issues. So we have to actually go beyond that. Right now, we are just using them as communication solutions, and that's why a company or a product which was not supposed to be a tech product got extensively used during this lockdown, which is your WhatsApp. Unka kahi kisi objective education nahi tha, but during this time, WhatsApp worked the best. Kyunki sabke paas wo available tha, aur abhi hume keval communication solution chahiye tha. But before this talk comes to an end, I would like to leave you with some food for thought. So there's something interesting to talk about if we meet next. this is the time which is, you know, you can visualize this as a golden period, because samaj mein aisa bahut kam baar hota hai that the society is ready to listen to you, is ready to experiment. Aur aisa keval tab hota hai when we as a community see an existential crisis. So if you ever wanted to experiment something in education, this is the right time. Do it right away, because your parents will listen to that experiment, they'll try to do that, your teachers will do that, everybody will be receptive. So aapko bhi bahut empathy se bhari hui hai, bahut adaptive, ek receptive community aapke paas hai. Agar aap abhi koi education experiment nahi karte hain, the future generations will actually be asking you a question ki jab aapko kuch nahi karna tha tab aap kya kar rahe the. And try to build the practice of writing an observation paper every single day. Bhale hi 200-250 words likhiye, lekin likhiye. Because what you can observe right now would become the basis of education innovation in the coming times. So keep writing, people, kyunki aap shayad bhool jaye, paper pe nahi bhoole. I hope you enjoyed the last 20-30 minutes with Love World. If you enjoyed, you can open your audio, say a big yes, and thank you so much for being a part of the Love World Web Talks 72nd edition. I hope you enjoy the whole experience. Thank
yes,
you.
Sir. Absolutely.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wonderful. I think everyone
thank
should
wonderful. Do
some,
sir. Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Bye.
Goodbye. Stay home. Stay safe.